This is Vince Russo's The Brand.
AlternaTV.
It's a big club, and you ain't in it.
Bogus.
Yes, Mr. Carlin, it's a big club, and we're not in the big club. Hello, everybody. Welcome again to another edition of AlternaTV. I'm your host, Brandon Stransky, and that is the theme of today's show. It's a big club, and we're not in it. Now, I'm sure you've all heard, you know, oh, secret dealings, people working behind the scenes, they're all working together. Well, the thing is, I'm here to say tell you that, yes, they are all working together. They all are on the same team. And there are some sub-teams that these people are members of that I'm going to expose one of them today. It is known as the Council on Foreign Relations. Now, for those of you who don't know what this is essentially a foreign policy think tank, or so they say. But in actuality, they, along with the Trilateral Commission and the Bilderberg Group, are what shapes all American and sometimes even world policies. These groups consist of members of foreign governments, media heads, politicians, lawmakers, and other people involved in government, and also the tops of industry and trade. And these people are all working together. They're all part of the same groups. And here's one. And I'm going to name them today. Unfortunately, I'm having a hard time trying to find a good comprehensive list of Trilateral Commission and Bilderberg attendees, so unfortunately today we'll be only concentrating on the Council on Foreign Relations, but when you see the people and the different backgrounds and just the different, how diverse a group of people this is should tell you, and that they're all working together for a common goal should tell you, that and then they spar and act like they hate each other or are rivals in front of the cameras, but they're working together in this group. So that should tell you something, that there's something going on. So we're going to tell you exactly who is behind what's going on in this country, why things are so bad. But before I get to that, I would like to give you a little bit of an update on the book I've been reading titled The Perestroika Deception, which you all should be reading. I will give you a heads up, if you go find that and read that and you happen to be either a communist, socialist, or some form of Marxist, it is going to kind of flip a lot of stuff you thought you knew. And honestly, you do need to have yourself slapped upside the head with this book and woken up. You have been lied to, you have been deceived, and you have been indoctrinated with Soviet propaganda, and you don't even know it, but we'll get to that in another show. Today, we're exposing the Council on Foreign Relations, so here we go. I found the list right here. Let's start reading them off so you see just who is working against us to try to bring us under their heel under the New World Order. Started off, corporate membership of the Council on Foreign Relations. We have Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, Chevron Corporation, ExxonMobil, Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan Chase, NASDAQ, President's Circle. We have some, I'm just going for the names that will probably resonate the most with people. American Express, Bloomberg LP, Citigroup, Coca-Cola, Dell, Deutsche Bank. Let's see, Lockheed Martin, Mars Incorporated, McGraw-Hill, Morgan Stanley, Parsons Corporation, Shell Oil Company, Soros Fund Management, that name should be ringing some bells, Soros, Toyota Motors, North America, premium members, let's take a look and see what familiar names we got here.
If you can't control your freaking wiener...
You're wishing this was on Realm Network. Well, what in the hell did you think the casting
couch
was?
For the sake of entertainment purposes, that was good podcasting.
We're in the ratings business.
Yes! Jim Cornette makes an appearance on Bucket Full of Chicken Necks. A bucket full of chicken necks.
Are there any happy endings?
To the house.
Bank of New York Mellon Corporation, Boeing, Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce. That's an interesting one. Let's see. ConocoPhillips. FedEx, General Electric, Google, Hitachi, IBM, InvestCorp, Microsoft, Mitsubishi, Americas, News Corporation, Pepsi, Pfizer, Prudential, Rothschild North America. That shouldn't surprise anybody. If you know who the Rothschilds are, you're already way ahead of the game. Sony Corporation of America. Time Warner. U.S. Chamber of Commerce. Volkswagen Group of America. Walmart. Western Union. Xerox. And here's some... Okay. Now we've got the corporations out of the way. Let's go and hit the members right... Where just nail the members. Some of these should really shock you because these are people who should be opposed to each other, but here they are in the same organizations working together to stick it up your ass. Roger Ailes, deceased former chairman and CEO of Fox News. Madeleine Albright, 64th United States Secretary of State, 20th United States Ambassador to the United Nations under President Bill Clinton. Lamar Alexander, current governor of Tennessee, former senator, and former Senate Secretary of Education under George H.W. Bush. Elliot Abrams, international lawyer, former State Department official under Reagan and Bush. C. John Abizade, U.S. Army General, former head of CENTCOM. Michael F. Adams, president of University of Georgia. See, that's how these kids are getting indoctrinated with all these Marxist socialist crap in colleges, is because you got these guys in the colleges spreading this bullshit. John B. Anderson, Republican congressman from Illinois. Bruce Babbitt, governor of Arizona, for Secretary of Interior under Clinton. Howard Baker, former senator, chief of staff under Reagan. James Baker, Secretary of State under Bush 41, Secretary of Treasury under Reagan, and Chief of Staff to Reagan and Bush. Thurbert Baker, former Democratic Party Attorney General of Georgia. Michael Barnes, former Congressman of Illinois, of Maryland. Sorry. Charlene Barshefsky, former United States Trade Representative. Evan Bea, Democratic Senator from and Governor of Indiana. Peter Bergen, journalist, national security analyst for CNN. Joe Biden, vice president and former senator. Josh Bolton, White House chief of staff under George W. Bush. Rudy Boschwitz, Republican senator from Minnesota. Nancy Berger, United States security advisor under Clinton. Warren Beatty, actor, producer, director. Howard Berman, former congressman, Democratic congressman from Illinois. Jeffrey Bukes, president of Time Warner. Sanford Bishop, U.S. Congressman, Democrat from Georgia. Michael Bloomberg, mayor of New York City and founder of current mayor of New York City and founder of Bloomberg LP. David Boren, former U.S. Senator from Oklahoma, current president of University of Oklahoma. Bill Bradley, former senator from New Jersey, NBA Hall of Fame basketball player. Richard Branson, founder of Virgin Group. Stephen Gerald Breyer, United States Supreme Court Justice. Bill Brock, former chairman of Republican Party, 8th U.S. Trade Ambassador and United States Secretary of Labor under Ronald Reagan, former senator from Tennessee. Dan Burton, former Republican congressman from Indiana. Aaron Burnett, journalist, CNN anchor. George H.W. Bush, 41st President of the United States. Tom Brokaw, NBC journalist. Edgar Bronfman Sr., member of Bronfman Dynasty, president of World Jewish Congress. Ethan Bronner, deputy foreign editor of New York Times. Zbigniew Brzezinski, 10th United States Security Advisor under President Jimmy Carter, and his daughter Mika on Morning Joe, if you ever catch that, is doing a great job of proving the old Leahy adage, the shit apple doesn't fall far from the shit tree true. If you get a chance, go out and look it up. She actually said one time on the air that it's the media, hers and the media's job to tell us what to think. It's YouTube, it is there. Let's see here. Jonathan S. Bush, healthcare CEO, son of Jonathan Bush, and brother of Billy Bush, who was there for that famous Trump grabbing by the pee thing. Craig Calhoun, director of London School of Economics, president and also president of the Bergerwin Institute. Frank Carlucci, Secretary of Defense under Reagan and Deputy Director of CIA under Carter. Jimmy Carter, 39th President of the United States. Juju Chang, journalist, reporter for ABC News. Dick Cheney, 46th Vice President of the United States. Henry Cisneros, United States Secretary of HUD under Clinton. Bill Clinton, 42nd President of the United States. Hillary Clinton, former First Lady, former Senator from New York, and Secretary of State under Barack Obama. George Clooney, need I say more? Stephen F. Cohen, Professor of Russian Studies at New York University. Katie Couric, CBS and NBC journalist, current talk show host. Edward Cox, former chairman of Republican New York Republican Party and son-in-law of Richard Nixon. Michael Crow, president of Arizona State University. Mario Cuomo, current governor of New York of the Democrat Party. William H. Daley, White House chief of staff under Obama, Secretary of Commerce under Clinton. Kenneth Duberstein, Chief of Staff under Reagan. Chris Dodd, former Senator from Connecticut, Democrat. Thomas Donahue, Secretary Treasurer of AFL-CIO. William H. Donaldson, former Chairman of United States Secretaries and Exchange Commission. Michael Dukakis, former Governor of Massachusetts and Democratic nominee for President in the 1988 election. Jesse Dillon, Director. John Edwards, former Democratic Senator from North Carolina and Vice President nominee in the 2004 election. Carl Eikenberry, United States Army General, former Ambassador to Afghanistan. Dianne Feinstein, United States Democratic Party Senator from California. Bernard T. Ferrari, Dean, Johns Hopkins University, Carey Business School. Donald Frazier, former Democratic Congressman from Minnesota. Bill Frist, Republican politician, former United States Majority Leader of the United States Senate. Thomas Friedman, columnist for New York Times. Martin Feldstein, economist, Harvard professor. Tom Foley, former Speaker of the United States House of Representatives. Pamela Gann, President of President of Claremont McKenna College. Former Dean of Duke University School of Law, Robert Gates, former Secretary of Defense under Bush and Obama, and Director of Central Intelligence under George H.W. Bush. Robert P. George, academic, professor at Princeton University. David Geffen, does that name sound familiar? He was the guy who signed Nirvana, and of course of the famous Geffen Group, and is the current president of Universal Music Group. Leslie Gelb, former journalist in New York Times. Sam Gejdensen, former Democratic Party current congressman from Connecticut. Jim Gilmore, former governor of Virginia. Alan Greenspan, former chairman of the Federal Reserve. Bob Graham, Democratic governor of Florida and former senator. Timothy Geithner, former Treasury Secretary under Obama and the 9th President of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. David Gergen, advisor to Richard Nixon, Gerald Ford, Ronald Reagan, and Bill Clinton, and also was the one who flipped out when Alex Jones confronted him about his ties to, Bohemian Grove. As much as I despise Alex Jones, he did nail that one right on the money. Ooh, I'm reading about this scumbag. Mikhail Gorbachev, former president of the USSR. Oh, I'm reading a bunch about this little pissant. Roy Goodman, former Republican member of the New York State Senate. Newt Gingrich, Republican representative and former Speaker of the House, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, current Supreme Court Justice. Lee Hamilton, Democratic Congressman from Indiana. Michael Hayden, United States Air Force General and National Security Agency Director under Bill Clinton and Director of CIA under George W. Bush. Gary Hart, former Senator from Colorado, Democrat, and board member for a Partnership for a Secure America. Heather Higgins, Women's Advocate, Chairman of Independent Women's Forum and President of the Randolph Foundation. Chris Hines, heir to the Hines ketchup fortune. Carla Hills, former Secretary of HUD and Trade Representative to George H.W. Bush. Warren Hogue, journalist formerly of the New York Times. Angelina Jolie, actress and UN Goodwill Ambassador. Woody Johnson, owner of the New York Jets and heir to the Johnson & Johnson fortune. Thomas Kean Sr., former governor of New Jersey, Republican. John Kerry, senator from Massachusetts, secretary of state under Obama, and former vice president nominee. And was also on tape saying, was also caught, and John Kerry, while secretary of state, was also caught on tape saying, a recording of him was leaked saying that he deliberately let ISIS grow to put pressure on Assad. Go check that out.
Jabron.
Oh, and look at that, his daughter's in there too. Isn't that cute? Another shit apple not falling far from the shit tree. Raymond Kelly, former police commissioner of the NYPD. Henry Kissinger, secretary of state under Nixon and Ford, and one of the biggest traitors this nation has ever seen. Joe Klein, Time Magazine columnist. Paul Krugman, economist, columnist for New York Times. Charles Krauthammer, columnist for Washington Post and political commentator at Fox News. Zalmay Khalilzad, 26th Ambassador to the United Nations under George W. Bush. Richard W. Larvier, scholar, president of University of Oregon. John Lewis, Democratic United States Congressman from Georgia, former and famed civil rights leader. Jim Lahier, journalist, former anchor for PBS. Joe Lieberman, former senator from Connecticut, Democrat, or independent, sorry. Let's see. John McCain, senator from Arizona, former presidential nominee for the Republican Party. George Mitchell, United Senate Majority Leader. Walter Mondale, former vice president. Les Moonves, president and CEO of CBS. Rupert Murdoch, founder, chairman, CEO of News Corp and Fox News. Heather Nauert, journalist, anchor for Fox News. Janet Napolitano, United States Third Secretary of Homeland Security under Obama and the 21st governor of Arizona. Sandra Day O'Connor, former United States Supreme Court Justice. Stan O'Neill, former CEO and chairman of the board at Merrill Lynch. George Pataki, former governor of New York, Republican. Henry Paulson, Secretary of Treasury under George W. Bush. David Petraeus, former general, former head of CENTCOM, and former director of CIA. Christina H. Paxson, former president of Brown University. Peter G. Peterson, Secretary of Commerce under Nixon. Kitty Pilgrim, journalist, anchor on CNN. I'm just sorry. I mean, I don't mean to be taking time trying to find the ones that are like, you know, would register most of the people and stuff, the ones that are most important. Colin Powell, former Secretary of State under Bush 40, Secretary of State under Bush 43, or George W. Bush. National Security Advisor under Reagan, and Joint Chairman of Joint Chiefs of Staff under Bush 41, George H.W. Bush. Charles Prince, former Chief Executive Group of Citicorp. Jennifer Robb, President of Hunter College. Janet Reno, former Attorney General, and as I like to call her, the Butcher of Waco. Condoleezza Rice, former Secretary of State under Bush, George W. Bush. Dan Rather, former anchor at CBS. David Rockefeller Jr., John D. Rockefeller, former Senator of West Virginia and former Governor of West Virginia, Charlie Rose, PBS journalist, Liz Rosenberg, columnist for Boston Globe, Chuck Robb, former Governor of Virginia. He also happens to be the son-in-law of LBJ, another shit apple not falling far from the shit tree. Robert Rubin, Secretary of Treasury under Bill Clinton, Haim Saban, former of Saban Capital Group, Diane Sawyer, ABC journalist. Timothy Shriver, chairman and CEO of the Special Olympics. Nancy Soderbergh, former UN ambassador. David Stern, commissioner of the NBA. George Shultz, former Secretary of State under Reagan, Secretary of Treasury, and Secretary of Labor under Nixon. Frederick W. Smith, CEO and founder of FedEx. Andrew Ross Sorkin, business journalist for New York Times and NBC. George Soros, big surprise there, that dude's a scumbag. Leslie Stahl, CBS News journalist. Donna Shalala, United States Secretary of Health under Bill Clinton, President of University of Miami. Eric Shinseki, Secretary of Veterans Affairs under Obama, Chief of Staff under Clinton and Bush. George Stephanopoulos, former White House Press Secretary under Bill Clinton, and this week with George Stephanopoulos hosts, Lawrence H. Silverman, United States Federal Judge, Robert Silvers, editor of New York Review of Books, Stansfield Turner, United States Navy Admiral, 12th Director of CIA under Jimmy Carter, Richard Thornburse, Attorney General under Reagan and Bush, former Governor of Pennsylvania. John L. Thornton, Brookings Institution, former President of Goldman Sachs. Tom Vilsack, former United States Secretary of Agriculture and former Governor of Iowa, and he served under Obama. Paul Volcker, 12th Chairman of the Federal Reserve. Barbara Walters, ABC journalist. Christine Todd Whitman, former governor of New Jersey and former administrator of the EPA under George W. Bush. James D. Wolfensohn, former president of the World Bank. Paul Wolfowitz, former president of the World Bank, former U.S. Deputy Secretary of Defense under Bush 43. James Woolsey, 16th Director of the CIA under Bill Clinton. No wonder he turned down the memorandums that an ex-KGB was sending to him about how the Soviet Union was trying to infiltrate and restructure the United States when Woolsey and Clinton were in on it themselves. They're part of it. Let's see. Paul Azan, journalist, former anchor at Fox News and CNN. Robert Zolik, 11th President of the World Bank. And that's about it. Oh, that was exhausting. That was exhausting. But there you have it. I named names. These people are all part of... and that's just one organization they're all part of. I'm sure there's a bunch of overlaps with all of them and some other parts where they're doing other... working on other projects and other ways to bring this world under the New World Order. Hourofthetime.com. Go check that out. Listen to the old broadcast of Bill Cooper. Go to his virtual library. Check out that information. That stuff is so valuable. Get yourself educated. And I will see you all next week. Good night and God bless you all.
This is Vince Russo's The Brand.